Hello, my name is Angela from Angela Simpson Functional Medicine Physiotherapy. Thanks for joining me. And today I'd like to talk about PMS and how it could be causing you some very debilitating symptoms in your life and how to actually fix it long term. And if you are in this category of suffering from PMS and you have been suffering for a long time, you probably are noticing that there are several aspects of your life being affected. It's probably affecting your relationships with your family, your loved ones, your friends, maybe even your work relationships. Often when people are suffering from PMS, there are some significant mood shifts at particular times in the cycle. And quite commonly, there's also some pelvic pain that goes along with this at various different times in the cycle. Often women do report that they have some bloating before they have their period, sometimes even around ovulation. They find that their bowel movements shift, their digestion shifts, it's very uncomfortable. And in general, they find that they have a lot of fatigue as well at various different points in the cycle. And if this is you and you're dealing with this month after month, and maybe you have been for years, you're probably fed up and you're probably really frustrated and looking for something that's actually going to help you long term. And you probably have tried several different things if you have been dealing with this for a long time. And I would like to speak with you about a specific client that I worked with that actually got through it and actually got her life back after she got rid of the PMS symptoms for the long term. And for her, it was a really rough road. She had been dealing with PMS basically since she started getting her cycles. She started to have severe pain, severe bloating, discomfort, and she felt like she would spend part of her month in bed around ovulation and before her period. And it just started to affect her life so much, especially as she became an adult. And she found that she would have her work and she'd have to phone in sick all the time. She started to run her own company and she found that she would have to phone in and get other people to work for her. It was starting to affect her productivity at her work. She found it was really tough to maintain an intimate and close relationship. She was in a lot of pain, so she found intercourse uncomfortable. And she had so many different shifts in her mood and her digestion at various different times in the cycle that it was almost impossible to maintain a relationship. So she found that she was just struggling in so many aspects of her life. And she tried a lot of different things. She tried birth control. She tried various different types of birth control. She tried an IUD. She tried working with an acupuncturist. She tried pain medication. She tried all kinds of different pain medication. She would have to increase and up the pain medication over time because it would work initially and then it would stop working as well. And after spending so much money on this and feeling like she actually had gotten nowhere, she was just about ready to give up. She said, I just have no life. I don't know what to do. It's starting to actually even affect my ability to have any employment. And she just didn't know what to do. And so this was the state when I first met her. And so what we had to do is we had to look at her history, a very detailed timeline. And through this, I was able to discover that as a child, she had some very adverse situations with her family. Her parents separated early. They both had health issues in and out of the hospital. So she had a hard time eating properly. She said she didn't actually eat a lot of healthy food when she was growing up, and she thinks this probably affected her. She also said she had sinus infections from the time she was a child on and off. She's been on antibiotics more times than she could count. And so there was all these different factors that had actually led to her having these imbalances in her body that were causing the severe PMS and pelvic pain. And so we really had to figure out where it was all coming from to help her get better. And through a very detailed plan and a very systemized approach, we were able to start working on some of the big general imbalances in her body through different foods and various different techniques to help her actually start rebalancing so that she could slowly start to get rid of that pelvic pain as well as those mood shifts and get her energy back. And it took time. It took 6 to 8 months for her to start to feel better, but she gradually started to feel better and better. She was able to come off pain medication. She was able to start working again. And she actually was able to get into more of a stable long-term relationship because she felt more regulated in all aspects of her life. And now she's feeling a lot better and she feels like she has her life back. But it took some work on both of our parts and it took a very detailed plan and with ongoing support to actually help her get to the other side of it and feel like she got her life back. And, you know, the flip side of this is she was ready to basically have a hysterectomy. She said there was days where she didn't even want to get out of bed and continue her life. So there can be very devastating effects if you don't deal with this. And often PMS too, it does signal that there are some big systems in your body of balance. And so if you don't manage this and actually turn it around, you can be at risk for several different conditions. You're more at risk for all of the inflammatory type conditions such as autoimmunity. If the hormones are out of balance, and this is also related to the PMS symptoms, you could be at risk for some different female cancers, especially as you get older and get closer to menopause, the risk goes up. You also potentially could be at risk for some different bone issues if your hormones are out of balance. There's many other things that can happen if you don't actually deal with the root cause of where this PMS is coming from, because it is often a symptom of other things in the body being out of balance that have been for quite some time. And so if you want to learn how you can get on top of your PMS and not just manage it month to month, but actually beat it and have it not come back on you over the long term and get your life back and feel better again and more balanced, please let me know, because I'm really happy to talk to you about this. I have dealt with it personally myself. I've learned how to manage it, improve on it, and get my life back. And I've helped countless women do this. And I just want to help people so much that are going through this, because I know how much it affects your life. So if you're interested in learning more, please feel free to contact me. And I'm happy to have a complimentary consult with you to talk about this. And we can talk about if it's a good fit for us to work together to help you optimize your health and get your life back. You can reach me at my website at www.angelasimpsonfunctionalmedicine.ca. Thanks for watching.